We're going to find in this week's parsha, I think, a little bit of a fresh nuance to a well-known yesod, a well-known concept. And it comes from a Maridika Svarno, the Svarno telling us something which is a little bit out of the norm. And if we understand it, if we dehear it properly, I think we can really change focus. An idea will help us out so much more as we go through life. The pasuk tells us, "V'achaltem l'soiva," that we will eat, we'll have our food in abundance, and we will eat to our fill, that will satisfy us. But yet the Torah tells us, a human nature is, we're going to ask ourselves, what's going to be in the seventh year? What are we going to eat? How are we going to have enough food in the seventh year? We might have enough now, but what's going to be later? What's going to happen to us? What's going to be? How am I going to manage? The typical questions. And what does HaKadosh Baruch Hu say in the next pasuk? V'tzivisi es birchasi lochem. Don't worry, I've commanded, I've given you my bracha, that you will have enough food. It's not going to be a problem, you're going to be taken care of. So the Sfarno asks, amongst other mefarshim, what's going on here? HaKadosh Baruch Hu only gives us his bracha, v'tzivisi es birchasi, only after we ask, what's going to happen, what's going to be in the seventh year? Let's say we never would have asked that question. Let's say we would have just remained quiet. That we wouldn't have gotten the bracha. What happened to v'achaltem l'soiva? That we're going to have enough food. So the Sfarno says something extremely fundamental. And he explains and he says, it was a chesaron in this that we asked the question. And this that we had to get this bracha. Because human nature is, we ask, what's going to happen? What's going to be? Well, where's the seventh year? Where's the food going to come from? So HaKadosh Baruch Hu says, don't worry. If you keep my mitzvahs and you listen to me and you keep Shemitah properly, I'm going to give you my bracha. Don't worry. You have nothing to worry about. But let's say you would never have asked that question, then you would have just had v'achaltem l'soiva. If you never would have asked the question, you would have had enough food to just last. There would have been an abundance. There would have been any issues whatsoever. There would have been no need for a bracha to begin with. As we know, Oichel Kima Misparach B'Meyav, HaKadosh Baruch Hu has the ability, as we've seen in our history, which is eating a little bit sustains us for so much longer. HaKadosh Baruch Hu would have made that which we would have had, would have lasted longer. That itself would have created more, that we wouldn't have had a need even to ask the question, to ask for a bracha, to daven, to be mispalo for anything more. That would have been the highest level of bracha. Only once, once you start asking questions, then HaKadosh Baruch Hu has to give you a bracha and has to come in and intervene. This is such an astounding idea. Many times when we go through life and we have different challenges that come up, be it small, be it big, we're asking ourselves, what's going to be? How am I going to manage? What's going to happen? But sometimes that's a level of betachin that we know we're talking to HaKadosh Baruch Hu and we know he's in charge. But can you imagine if we're holding at a level of betachin so secure with HaKadosh Baruch Hu that we don't even have to ask questions? If I know, a child knows that when he cries, a parent's going to take care of them. So sometimes they know their needs are met. They don't have to cry because they know a mother's going to feed the child a certain amount of time. They know they're going to sit down to supper. The family, the mother's going to have food for them. They don't have to ask for it. It's given. And that's what we have to realize, that HaKadosh Baruch Hu gives us. Dei machsarai. That HaKadosh Baruch Hu gives us everything we have, but it's going to be our parnasa. We don't even have to cry for it. We don't have to worry what's going to be. Daigas macha, we'll worry about what's going to happen tomorrow, what's going to happen a week from now, what's going to happen with my children, what's going to happen with Klal Yisrael. Don't worry, relax. HaKadosh Baruch Hu is going to take care of us. If you ask questions, that's a different level. And HaKadosh Baruch Hu will have to answer them one way or another. But the highest form is that you're so secure, you're so at peace, you're so tranquil. You're so b'menuchas ha-nefesh because you're living with HaKadosh Baruch Hu that there's not even a need to ask any questions. And that Chazal tell us, I forgot from who points this out, that that's what happened to Kriyas Yamsuf. Klal Yisrael is sitting there, they're camped, they're chonu al hayam, they're camped by the sea. They see the Mitzrayim running after them. And they're not holding on that extreme level of betachon. And therefore they're crying out, HaKadosh Baruch Hu, what's going to be? Moshe Rabbeinu, what are you doing to us? Look what's happening. The Mitzrayim are going to kill us. You took us out and now they're going to destroy us. And we have nowhere to go. And what does Moshe Rabbeinu tell them? Hashem yilochem lochem v'atem tacharishon. Hashem, if you're holding by a certain level, realize Hashem is going to fight for you. V'atem tacharishon, and you be quiet. And you be silent. If you stop asking questions and you're silent, then HaKadosh Baruch Hu will be able to fight for you fully. Because that's really what's happening all the time. So don't ask questions. There's no need to ask. There's no need to cry out. There's no need to worry. When we say we're asking questions, we're asking, we're worrying. Stop worrying. Don't worry. HaKadosh Baruch Hu is taking care. Hashem yilochem lechem. Hashem will fight for you. So if we realize this idea, this level, we'll take the lesson of Shemitah. Not that we're so worried what's going to happen during the seventh year, but the more importantly, V'achaltam Asayva, HaKadosh Baruch Hu is taking care of us day in and day out. And on the higher level, we don't ask for questions, then even the little bit that we do will sustain us for so much longer. Have a wonderful Shabbos.